You're listening to the Keith Blakemore-Noble Radio Show, helping you transform your deepest fears into your greatest strengths. Here's your host, Keith Blakemore-Noble.
Hey, hello, welcome to another episode, and today we are talking all about motivation. We're going to look at what motivation is. We're going to look at the key behind motivation. There is a really simple, powerful key behind all motivation, which really explains why sometimes you're motivated and sometimes you're just not. And you can use this key to really kick your motivation into overdrive. We're going to look at the implications for what's called, some of you may have heard of, toward and away from motivation. We're going to look how this all fits together. And we're going to look at what you can do to help you really get your motivation back. That's what we're going to cover today. Let's get on with it. Let's dive in. So what do we mean by motivation? Motivation is that thing which gets us going. It kicks our butt, gets us moving in the right direction, gets us doing the things we want to do. We kind of all know what motivation is. But have you noticed how so often we're kind of going along, things are well, and then you just run out of motivation? Yeah. You just can't be bothered with it anymore, or it just seems a bit too, why am I doing this? And you sort of remind yourself, oh, I'm doing this because dot, dot, dot. But it still doesn't get your motivation going. You ever had that? It's not just me, right? You have it as well, yeah? So what's going on with motivation? At its most basic, motivation is all about pain minimization. Motivation is nothing more, nothing less than pain minimization. That is the fundamental secret, the fundamental key to motivation. When you get this right, and we'll have a look at how you can do that, when you get this right, your motivation becomes unstoppable. But when you find yourself stuck in a rut, when you find your motivation has run out, your get up and go has got up and left, it's because you've fallen foul of this very, very simple principle. Motivation is all about pain minimization. And that even applies when we talk about away from and toward motivation, which is big in terms of goal setting. We'll take a look at how this impacts that later on. Just for those who are wondering, if you haven't come across the terms, away from motivation is where you're motivated to move away from what you don't want. Toward motivation is where you're motivated to move toward what you do want. And all the talk is that away from motivation is moving away from pain, whereas toward motivation is moving toward pleasure. And away from motivation is quick, but peters out very quickly. Whereas toward motivation, moving toward the pleasure, apparently is longer lasting and will get you there. We'll actually take a look at what's really going on there, because so often when we set goals and we use the toward motivation, we still find we run out of motivation. We'll take a look at what's going there and how you can counteract that as well. So, what do I mean by motivation is all about pain minimization? Well, that's exactly it. When your perceived levels of pain about the situation you are in are greater than the level of pain you perceive it will take to change that situation, you will be motivated to make a change. When the level of pain, or the level of pain that you perceive about the situation you're in, is greater than the level of pain involved in changing that situation, you will be motivated to change. It is that simple, is that fundamental, is that basic? On the other hand, if your perceived level of pain in making the change is greater and your perceived level of pain in staying where you are, now that's where your motivation is not going to get you through. You are not going to be motivated, because it's going to hurt more to change than to stay where you are. You're not going to change. That's what's going on. When you find you run out of motivation, your motivation has petered out, it's because in that moment, what you perceive as a level of pain in order to change is greater than what you perceive as a level of pain to stay where you are. It's fundamental to how motivation works. Give a very simple examples. If you put your hand on a hot stove, the pain of staying where you are is very big, right? The pain of keeping your hand there is immense. It is literally pain. It really does hurt. You will be motivated to move it because your perceived levels of pain in moving your hand away from there are much, much lower. Therefore, you will move your hand away. On the other hand, suppose you've really badly stubbed your toe, for example. The pain of staying where you are, your level of, perceived level of pain of staying where you are, could actually be less than your perceived level of pain in moving to another location, because it's going to hurt more to move, so you're going to stay where you are. Yeah? That's what is going on with pain and with motivation. So, when you're looking to get motivated, and you find you're lacking in motivation, it's time to consider the levels of pain, your perceptions of the levels of pain. It's not the absolute level of pain, it's what you perceive those levels of pain will be. Because very often, when we make changes, we believe it's going to hurt a lot more than it does. And I don't just mean pain in the physical sense. I mean pain as it could be financial pain, emotional pain. It could just be the pain of not knowing what you're doing. Could be discomfort, all of these sorts of things. So that's what we mean by pain. It's not necessarily physical pain. It's any kind of pain or discomfort in any aspect or area of your life. So when you find your motivation is gone, it's because it feels more comfortable to stay where you are in that moment than it does to change. A classic example, harking back to New Year's resolutions, which we spoke about a couple of episodes ago, people will often have the resolution, I'm going to take up jogging, I'm going to take up running, yes, because it's going to get me nice and fit, fantastic. And the first maybe 2, 3, 4 nights, they go out jogging. And then there's a night when it's pouring rain and it's freezing cold and it's probably blowing a bit of a gale as well. It's like, do I really want to go out in that? All of a sudden, your motivation goes. Because going out in that weather, the pouring rain, the wind, the cold, it's not nice. It's painful in so many ways. Now motivation disappears. We decide to skip that night. And then we skip the next night because it's not particularly nice weather. And then we skip the next night because, hey, there's something good on telly and we don't want to miss it, right? And before you know it, you've fallen off the bandwagon. You've stopped your jogging. What can you do in that situation? What can you do to stop your motivation disappearing or to recapture your motivation and to get even stronger motivation? Well, people will often say, look at why you started on this in the first place. And yeah, that is a significant part of it. When you look at why, look at the pain that's involved. Why did you take up jogging? Because you want to be fitter and healthier, for example. Why do you want to be fitter? Well, quite frankly, you don't want to die of heart failure in 10 years' time because you've been sat on the sofa the whole time. You don't want to put your family through losing you because you couldn't be bothered to exercise and to look after yourself. Really, really get in touch with that pain. Remind yourself, it's not just, oh, I wanted to take up jogging so I could get fitter. That's nice. Why did you want to get fitter? What is the pain in staying where you are? The pain of staying where you are is, yes, it'll be nice and comfortable, but hey, you're comforting yourself into potentially an early grave. Well, that kind of sucks, right? And even if you don't die sooner rather than later, you're going to be less and less fit. It's going to be more and more of a struggle to do things. You're not going to be able to join in with your mates when they play footy down the park. You're not going to be able to go out for walks or whatever it is because you abandon that fitness. Get in touch with the levels of pain about what hurts so much about staying where you are. Once that level of pain is suitably high, such that it's higher than the pain or discomfort of making the change, you will do it. Yeah, you might not enjoy that jogging in the rain, but you know what? Because you've got it in mind, I'm doing this because if I don't, it's going to hurt even more. And let's face it, okay, I'm going to be jogging in the rain for what, half an hour? Then I get a nice warm shower at the end of it. Huh, that's not so bad actually. Yeah, I've got to slog through this, and then a nice warm shower after, and I get that nice feeling of accomplishing this. And you know what, it's going to get easier each time I do it. So the pain gets less and less. So basically, look at the levels of pain. Motivation is all about pain minimization. When the pain of staying the same is greater than the pain of changing, you'll change. When the pain of staying the same is less than the pain of changing, you'll stay the same. And I talk about the pain of changing. It can be the pain involved in changing, or it can be the pain of getting to where you're getting to your destination. And it all counts as the same thing. Now, I mentioned a few moments ago that this also really ties in with toward and away from motivation. So let's take a good look at this, because very fundamental part of goal setting and teaching goal setting is we always talk about make sure your goals are toward motivated, toward oriented, toward what you do want rather than away from it, what you don't want. Make sure your goals are about the pleasure, not about the pain. That's what's going to see you through. That's what's going to make longer lasting goals. How does that fit in with us saying that motivation is just pain minimization? What's going on there? Well, let's take a look. Why we talk about toward motivation as being more powerful than away from motivation. Consider this. Suppose you'd set a goal because you don't want to be broke. I don't want to be broke. I don't want to have no money. I don't want to be broke. That is your goal. That's your aim. Yeah? So you're moving away from what you don't want. I don't want to be broke. Now, there's two things going on here. First, there is the concept that the mind can't focus on negatives. Don't think of a green elephant. Oops, you're thinking of a green elephant. So when you're talking about, I don't want to be broke, you're focusing on being broke. Because in order to know that you're not broke, you have to know what it's like to be broke, yeah? In order to know whether you're broke or not. So you've got your mind, at least in part, focusing on being broke, which is not necessarily, not really a particularly helpful thing for your mind to concentrate on. But also what happens is, you get a little bit of money, and then your mind goes, hey, I'm not broke. I don't have to carry on doing whatever I was doing, because I'm not broke anymore. Goal achieved, tick that one off the list, sorted. Of course, you take your eye off the ball and then your levels of money fall again. And oh, shoot, I'm broke. Oh, I don't want to be broke. I don't want to be broke. So you go through this cycle of I don't want to be broke. I've got a bit of money. It's fine. I don't want to be broke. I've got a bit of money. It's fine. You ever been there, right? People do it with dieting, yo-yo diets. They go on a diet, lose weight, come off the diet, go back. On another diet, lose weight, come off the diet, go back. Yo-yo dieting, because we're moving away from what we don't want. When we talk about toward motivation, we're always focusing on what we do want. So instead of, I don't want to be fat, it might be, I want to weigh this, or I want to be this dress size. Instead of, I don't want to be broke, it could be, I want to have £10,000 in the bank, as an example. So you will keep focusing on getting and maintaining whatever it is that you're looking to achieve, whether it's your dress size, whether it's your weight, whether it's your running speed, whether it's the amount of money you have in the bank, whether it's that nice house that you want, whatever it is, you'll keep focused on that. Your eyes will be focused on the price, so all your attention will keep focusing on that. So you won't have this yo-yo dieting, this always broke bit of money, broke bit of money, broke situation. And that is very, very true. However, you knew there was a however coming, right? However, the problem with this is we can still find that we reach a point where our motivation disappears. It gets really hard to keep pushing through. What's going on? Because I'm really focusing on the prize, but why does my motivation disappear? Again, it's all about pain minimization. So yes, you're focusing on what you do want, but when your motivation disappears, because at that point in your mind the pain of doing what you need to do to get that thing is greater than the pain of being where you are. And so your motivation disappears and you stay where you are. Yeah, I want that nice house, but oh man, it's hard doing all this work. Oof. Yeah. How can we overcome this? Well, yes, have your goal of I want that house. And each step of the way, focus on what you're moving away from. Focus on the pain. And in this case, the pain is the pain of not having that house. Really get in touch with how much it hurts to not have it. Why is that house so important to you? What does it get for you? What does it get for your family? Why is that important to you all? What does having that house enable you to do? Why is that important? How much does it hurt not having that house? And if it's doesn't really hurt that much because I've already got a house, so it's not the end of the world. Yeah, wonder why your motivation disappears. Yeah. But when you find you've got this aching for that goal, it really hurts. Every day you don't have that goal is like a stabbing pain through your heart. When you get into that level of it, whatever obstacles you face along the way, they're going to be nothing compared with the pain of not actually achieving that goal. That's where this all fits in. So yes, create your goals as toward what you do want, because that will give you something for which to aim and that will keep you going. But keep in mind, all motivation is about minimizing pain. So keep in mind, when your motivation starts to drop, as it will, it inevitably will, and that happens to all of us. When that happens, check in with the reason that you're achieving that goal. Yes, look at the positives and look at why that's important. Look at what you can't do now that you will do when you have that. Or look at what you can't have now that you will have when you achieve your goal. Look at how much it hurts to have not achieved that goal. Why does it hurt? Why is it so important? Shift that pain balance and your motivation will drag you through whatever it is that's holding you back. Because remember, all motivation is about pain minimization. Now, I don't mean you should always be focusing on pain the whole way that you're going through life. That would be a horrible way to live life, always looking at nothing but the pain. Oh, that would be an awful way. Yes, look on the positives. Focus on what you're seeking to achieve. Focus on how great it's going to feel. And use that to inspire your motivation to drag you forward. And when it isn't, check in with the pain. Remind yourself of just how much it hurts to make this change. But you know what? If I don't make this change, in the long run, it's going to hurt me even more. It's like when you've got a plaster on, yeah? And you want to take it off. It's like, oh, ow, 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 because it's catching on all the hairs and the skin. You're going, ow, 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 oh, no, I don't, I'll just leave this on. You know it's going to be a pain to take it off. But you also know you have to take it off because ultimately it's not going to be good for you. So that's why you're prepared to rip the plaster off, short bit of pain. In the longer run, it's going to be better for you. But until you see and understand that it's less painful in the long run, you're not going to go through that short burst of pain. And so it is with everything else we do. That is the fundamentals of motivation. It's all about pain minimization. Yes, this is something that's not often spoken about, not often taught, because we're always taught about, oh, don't look at the pain, look at the positives. Always focus on the positive. Be positive. Positive thinking. Look at what you will achieve. It's almost as if we are not allowed to acknowledge that pain exists, because if we dare to acknowledge pain exists, it's going to be the end of our life. No. Don't dwell in the pain. Don't dwell in pain, obviously, but use the pain to tip the balance to enable your motivation to be strong enough to get you through whatever short-term issues you have so that you can achieve that longer-term goal. Because when you're looking to achieve a goal, when you start out, it's going to look fairly easy, fairly straightforward. And then you're going to hit major obstacles. That's when it really gets hard. That's when your motivation drops. Tip that balance so that the pain of going through this barrier is still less than the pain of not getting the goal. That's what's going to enable you to get through that barrier. That's it, basically. That's all I wanted to talk about today, motivation. That is the fundamental key to motivation. When you get that, and not all of us do, but when you get that, you can use that to rekindle your motivation anytime. Anytime your motivation is starting to drop even. Revisit the pain balance, the pain equation, making sure that you understand why it hurts more to not go for the goal than it hurts going for the goal. That's what's going to get you through. What do you reckon? What's your thoughts on this? Make sense? Load of nonsense? Spark some curious thoughts going on? Let me know what you think. Let's have a conversation. Let's have a discussion. Wherever you're catching this, whether you're watching it or listening to it, pop in some comments or go onto my Facebook page or website. Pop in some comments. Let's have a discussion about it. If you like this, wherever you caught this, hit like, rate us, give us a good rating. Subscribe. Recommend it to your friends as well. And let me know what you think. And I will catch you in the very next episode. But until then, take care. Look after yourself. And remember, change is always possible. And when you change your mind, you change your life.
You've been listening to the Keith Blakemore-Noble Radio Show, helping you transform your deepest fears into your greatest strengths. To find out more, please visit keithblakemorenoble.com.